Okay, so I'm going to talk about wood mechanical properties, and I'm going to talk about loading of wood, which is very important when you design wooden structures. Now, wood is slightly odd material to use for structural purposes because it behaves in a slightly different way from a great many things. It's a viscoelastic material. This tends to frighten people because they think it means it's unpredictable, and it's not unpredictable, it's completely predictable. But you have to understand what viscoelastic means. So basically, if we have a beam, if we have a wooden beam, and that wooden beam is applied under a load, so we're doing a three-point load here, that beam will deform as a consequence of the load. So the load's being applied there, and there's the load, and of course the beam is deforming because every action has an opposite and equal reaction. So if it didn't deform, it wouldn't be able to react to the applied load. So this is standard material behavior. And that sort of behavior, once we remove the load, that material will return to its original shape. That sort of behavior is called elastic behavior. Okay, so it's a bit like a spring. You apply a load, the material deforms. Take away the load, the material returns to its original shape. All materials do this. You may not notice that they're doing it, but everything has this elastic behavior. And the amount that it deforms by with a constant load is determined by something called a Young's modulus. There's an S missing there. Modulus. Or sometimes it's just called modulus. So it's the amount by which a material deforms when a load's applied. I've talked about this elsewhere in this course. So that's elastic behavior. There's also a property that wood has, that you apply a load in exactly the same way, and the material deforms because that's what materials do when you apply loads to them. And then you take the load away and the material doesn't return to its original shape. Now that is not elastic. That is a viscous behavior. But wood's slightly peculiar in the way that it behaves, because if you leave it for enough time, it will return to its original shape. So that isn't viscous behavior. So we give that a name of delayed elastic. It depends how long you've been loading it for. And it depends how long you leave it for. So this is a time-dependent behavior. Finally, you can have the same setup. Apply a load, the material deforms. Under the load, you remove the load, and it stays like that. And you leave it for a very long time, and it still has a deformation, a permanent deformation. That is a viscous behavior, because there's this permanent change of shape. And wood can display all three of these types of behavior, which makes it slightly more complicated than a great many materials that are used in construction. It's well understood, but it needs to be considered when you design structures. And if you look at very old wooden buildings, you'll quite often see that they are quite interesting shapes. They're not necessarily straight lines in them, which makes them rather attractive. But They probably weren't built like that in the first place. It's just that over a long period of time, this deformation has taken place because there's a constant load being applied. So look at roof beams. Look at the roofs from the outside. You'll see that old buildings, the roof tends to be slightly curved. That type of behavior is also referred to as creep. So we have viscous behavior, delayed elastic behavior, and elastic behavior. And wood can demonstrate all three of these properties. And the thing that controls the sort of behavior that you see is the duration of load.